మేడం పిపిటి కనిపిస్తుంది మేడం మేడం
హలో
ఎస్ మేడం ఐ విల్ షేర్ అగే
కనిపించట్లేదు ఓకే సార్ నాకు కనిపిస్తుంది
So, obtaining the observable canonical form through the signal flow graph. For that, you need to draw the appropriate signal flow graph. That is clearly given in that example problem that I have given to you, and I asked you to solve it. Okay? Hope you have solved the problem. Also, I asked you to obtain the controllable canonical form also through the signal flow graph. That is also very important, and it will be like a practice if you solve it. What we did and we obtained the controllable canonical form using the phase variable form, instead of obtaining the phase variable form, we can also obtain the controllable canonical form also through the signal flow graph. The conclusion or the key point or the final point is we can obtain any kind of state space representation with the help of the signal flow graph. Only thing is we should able to draw the appropriate signal flow graph. For that you need to practice how to draw the signal flow graph according to our requirement. The idea is you have to draw the signal flow graph in such a way that you can write the equation for s into x of s. Okay, what is s into x of s? The first order derivative, that is x dot of t in time domain, it will be in s into x of s in Laplace domain. So s into x of s ane equation raaskune vidhanga meer signal flow graph draw cheyali. At the same time it should give you the appropriate state space representation, whether it may be parallel form, cascade form, OCF, CCF, all these things. Okay, also one more thing I told you, to take any problem from any textbook, preferably which are having the solutions or answers, and you obtain all the formats of the state space representation, that is parallel form, cascade form, especially controllable canonical form, observable canonical form, and finally Jordan canonical form. These are there in the syllabus, so that is why you should be able to obtain these three formats for any given problem or for any given transfer function. Okay, hope you have completed the task. So this is the syllabus. So these are what we have learned till now. Okay, state space representation, and we were looking at transfer function to state space. I hope I have given you all the formats, all the methods, have covered extensively. Converting a transfer function into state space, so state space representation of any system, the first point is using the dynamics of the system by writing the minimum number of the equation of the system. That is the basic thing if you know the system. Coming to second and third, if you know the transfer function, how to obtain the state space representation? One form is through the phase variable form, second form is through the signal flow form. In phase variable form, the idea is considering the output and its n minus 1 derivatives as state variables. In signal flow graph, the idea is you should draw the appropriate signal flow graph, and you should make sure that you can write or you can obtain the equation of derivative, that is s into x of s at any cost. So the other facts, so these are the other facts that also also we learned in the last class, that is using signal flow graph, all the formats can be obtained. Second one is parallel form gives the decoupled equations. It is very, very important. I will take an extra class on how to get the decoupled equations, how to solve decoupled equations. That is very important, but not in the syllabus, but not there in the syllabus. It is very important to understand the concept, to understand the state space analysis completely. I will take an extra class. I will tell you later, and I will complete the decoupled equations, how to solve the decoupled equations. If interested persons can join, that will be very useful for your GATE exam, especially. You will definitely get a question and you can easily solve. I will give you the very easy methods. So decoupled equations have got very important. Their importance is dominant in the state space analysis. As of now, we know that parallel form gives the decoupled equations. And third point we have seen is dual differential, CCF and OCF are dual to each other. So I think we have spent more than enough time to learn how to convert a given transfer function into state space. I hope all the methods I have given, all the examples you might have solved. Next, let us see small. The reverse process, easy process, that is state space to transfer function. Since the final format is transfer function, the given state space representation must not contain any initial conditions. It must be a single input, single output system. Why? Because we are going towards transfer function. Means whatever the properties of transfer function, all should obey by that given state space. Okay? It should not have any initial conditions. It should not have any non-linearities in it. It should not be time variant. That is, it should be time invariant. All those things, you know. Any representation of system in state space should give you the same transfer function. So what is this? This is important. I told you already, for a single system, there may be number of representations. Example, CCF, OCF, parallel form, cascade form, all these things. But if you convert them reverse, okay, if you convert them reverse to the transfer function, all should give same transfer function. Okay? State space representation is different, but whereas transfer function is unique. The transfer function representation is unique. We will get only one transfer function for a single input, single output system. Okay? Only one transfer function. It means the parallel form, cascade form, CCF, OCF, when you convert all of these formats back, they should give the same answer. They should give the same answer, that is single answer, that is transfer function. That is very important. This is the state space representation. So we are now dealing with the reverse process, state space to transfer function. So this is the state space representation. Since we are converting to the transfer function is nothing but the Laplace domain approach. So let us immediately convert the given state space equation into Laplace transform. Assume initial conditions are zero. It is nothing strange that since we are converting into transfer function, means the system should not have any initial conditions. Even though there are initial conditions, we should neglect them. That is the assumption of transfer function. So that is why we are assuming initial conditions as zero. So it will directly give you S into X of S is equal to A into X of S plus B into U of S, and Y of S is equal to C into X of S plus B into U of S. So after converting, try to separate the X of S. To separate the X of S. What is transfer function? It is the output by input, Laplace of output by input. So where is there in the output term is there in the output equation. So what we do, the idea is first we obtain X of S, first we obtain x of s by solving this equation. And later we substitute that x of s in this equation. That is the idea. First we solve the state equation and we obtain x of s. And then we substitute that x of s in the output equation. Now the output equation is having only output term and input term. Take the ratio of output and input, that will be your transfer function. So that is the idea. So let us see. First obtain what you call x of s. So for obtaining x of s, separate the x of s. So x of s, bring this x of s term to this side and take x of s common. Take x of s common, you will get it. Si minus A, Si minus A, where I is the identity matrix. Identity matrix. You should remember all the time that state space equations are nothing but the equations in the matrices. In the matrix, they are not simply the algebraic equations, single element equations. They are not like that. They are equations of matrices. Equations of matrices. So to satisfy that equation, if you common this, we will get this identity matrix. There is nothing difficult to understand. Since we are dealing with matrices, we will get identity matrix here. So after converting, this is the final x of s equation. Now we should substitute this here. We should substitute this here. That is the value. Substituting that in that equation, I will give you the equation in the next slide. So this is the next slide. Is the identity matrix of we will get the long equation. So this is x of s. Again, taking common, we get this. So this is input, this is output. Take the ratio of output by input, you will get. This is the transfer function. This is the transfer function. For any number of state variables or for any state space representation, if you solve for this matrix, what are D here? D is a matrix, B is a matrix, A is a matrix, I is a matrix. Even though we are solving with matrices, we will get final number of elements of this final matrix, that is P of S, Y of S, by U of S, is 1 by 1. That is 1 by 1. Finally, we will remain with only one element, that is nothing but your transfer function. We will remain with only one element, that is transfer. To solve an example, you can easily get this. Only thing is, you should be able to obtain the inverse of the matrix. From matrices, you might have studied there how to obtain inverse of matrix. So it is the adjoint matrix divided by determinant of that matrix. So if you don't know, please refer to the matrices once. SS to PM. So here, what I am doing, I am not solving any problems or I am not giving any example to you. So it is your duty to solve. Okay. What should you solve? You take all the problems that we have solved, that is transfer function to state space, transfer function to state space. We have wrongly mentioned here. So this is the reverse. PF to SS. So in the previous classes we have solved PF to SS problem. You take all the problems and you convert them to the reverse, that is SS to PF. You take the SS and you convert all of them to the as and you verify your answers whether you are getting correctly or not. That is one task. And second task is all these things, all these. Okay, it is already 9:20. Why still some persons are entering now? I don't know. Okay. Don't join late. Join the class before 10 minutes or join the class sharp by 9 AM or sharp by the scheduled time. Don't irritate us by joining in the middle of the class. Even though you join, if you don't present at least 90%. Suppose the class is conducted for 50 minutes. Class is conducted for 50 minutes. 90% of that is 45 minutes. If you don't present there in the class for 45 minutes, I will put absent. From today onwards, I will follow that. Because your complete login duration will be available for us through the report. If we generate report, how much time each student has there in the class, it will clearly visible. So I will see that and I will put present only to those students who are there more than 90% of the time. More than 90%. Suppose if the class is for 40 minutes, you should be there at least 36 minutes. The class is there for 50 minutes, you should be there at least 45 minutes. From today onwards, I will follow them. Please don't irritate by coming to the waiting room in between the class. And don't say that, don't ask us to admit without attendance. Okay? This is not regular process, regular class to do that. You yourself just don't join after 9:05. Okay. So you should do that. Okay. You convert all the controllable canonical form, observable canonical form, cascade form, parallel form, database, if you convert all of them and back into transfer function and you verify yourself. And once you get answers correctly, you will definitely get the satisfaction that you learned this completely, and this is the correct answers will give you the confidence regarding the subject. Okay. If you don't solve and if you just simply listen the class and if you leave it, you will get nothing. Okay. Try and verify the answers. And only thing is, you have to obtain the inverse of SI minus A matrix. Okay, you have to obtain SI minus A whole inverse. And you remember this matrix from now onwards. SI minus A whole inverse. From now onwards, you will be getting this matrix and inverse of this matrix very frequently. So you should be able to identify, you should be able to write the matrix first. That is SI minus A, you should be able to develop. Later, you should be able to get the inverse of that matrix. That is, you should do little practice to get that. So that is about the reverse process. Solution state space to transfer. State space to transfer. హలో మేడం. హలో మేడం.